back when I started watching Adventure Time, something dawned on me. That show is really well paced. So yeah, Adventure Time is well written. People kept telling me that for years, but what I'm getting at is that I never really felt like an episode dragged on longer than it should, and I was quite impressed by things Adventure Time did in 10 minutes, while MLP sometimes has problems telling a proper story in 40. Not that I'm saying that the writing in MLP is bad. It is pretty good, and some of my favorite MLP episodes are some of my favorite cartoon episodes, period. But it made me think, are some MLP episodes too long for their own good? Should they only be 10 minutes long? Of course, that's not gonna be anytime soon, but I think it's a worthwhile discussion, especially since Amy Keaton Rogers once mentioned in an interview that the Ticketmaster was originally meant to be 11 minutes long, and that she helped Lauren Faust to flesh out the script and fill a 20-minute time slot. And that actually makes some sort of sense. Compared to other episodes, not a lot actually happens in the Ticketmaster. The plot is paper-thin, and while it is rather enjoyable, it does feel padded out at times. Of course, in theory, the Ticketmaster should be the only episode affected by that decision. Every other episode should have been written with 20 minutes in mind, but frankly, not every episode feels like it. Season 6 was actually a pretty bad offender in that regard. Go and watch a couple of different Season 6 reviews, especially those of more negative received episodes. I bet you hear criticisms like, this scene dragged on, or that scene was unnecessary, and the ever so popular that musical number felt forced. And I'm not making fun of anyone using those arguments, I use them myself. A lot. And that's a problem I want to highlight. When every second reviewer agrees that a scene is unnecessary, it might be a bit unnecessary. It just seems like those episodes are struggling to fill the entire 20-minute runtime. Heck, that's pretty much the only reason why we even have had bad episodes in Season 6. As far as I can tell, the most disliked episode of that season was The Cart Before the Ponies, beside maybe Newbie Dash. Oh, that one is more controversial than anything else. Anyway, as I pointed out in my review of The Cart Before the Ponies, there's nothing really wrong with it on paper. Everyone acts more or less in character, even if it highlights Ardy's, AJ's and Rarity's worst traits. What makes this episode actually seem bad is that it drags on. There's not much happening other than the Crusaders trying to speak up only to be ignored time and time again and being told that they should have said something earlier. And that's it. This episode hammers in that the Crusaders are not happy with the situation, and seeing the adults ignoring them the entire time gets old rather fast. Most of that, by the way, happens in a montage. That montage mainly serves the purpose to pad out the running time, but it is also the main reason why the adults look like complete jerks in the end. The song at the end is not much better in that regard, and what is probably this episode's greatest sin, it's simply not that funny. There are a couple of good jokes, like Rarity's flashback, but this episode is more focused on making Ardy, AJ, and Rarity look bad. But if we were to cut down the episode to 10 minutes, the amount of jokes would be exactly right and the adults wouldn't seem that bad. The same would hold true for other episodes as well. Let's take for example the aforementioned Newbie Dash. This episode has several problems. But perhaps one of the most common criticisms is that the Rainbow Dash impersonating her friend's bit is the most cringiest scene in the entire episode and that it's way longer than it needs to be. Well, if Newbie Dash was only 10 minutes long, it would probably be the first thing to go, as the joke frankly overstays its welcome and only pads out the running time. And that scene is already 3 minutes long. With the worst part removed, it is not that hard to cut out another 7 minutes. However, the two episodes that would benefit the most from having a short running time are, in my opinion, the one where Pinkie Pie Knows and What About Discord. Both basically tell only one joke. In the one where Pinkie Pie Knows, it's about Pinkie Pie having to keep a secret, even though she wants to tell everyone the exciting news of Caden's pregnancy. I think that the episode starts out really funny. However, as soon as Shining Armor and Caden arrive and send the main six on that scavenger hunt, the joke is basically dead. What About Discord is pretty similar in that regard. The joke is that Twilight doesn't get the joke, because she wasn't there. But neither was the audience. That works for a couple of minutes, but as the episode drags on, it simply gets annoying to sit through. The tight pacing of a 10-minute episode would prevent the joke from getting stale. Of course, a 10-minute runtime can't save every episode, and a lot also benefit from being longer. I love Steven Universe, but it has a couple of episodes that manage to bore me even though they are only 10 minutes long. In general, I think that writers should be flexible in that regard. If you can fill 20 minutes with your script, go for it. But before you let Zephyr Bree sing a Rever 4 song, I'd rather take a 10-minute episode. Just make sure that the show keeps its 30-minute time slot and either give us a 20-minute episode or two that are 10 minutes long. Of course, if you make your episode shorter, there should be more of them. I don't want the production team to slack off after all. So if we cut the running time in half, I expect them to produce 52 episodes instead of 26. While the stories might be a bit shorter, we would get more stories overall. The question of course is what to do with them, and that's where I would like to bring up Adventure Time again. Especially in the later seasons, Adventure Time makes excellent use of its cast. Unlike MLP, in which pretty much every episode centers around the main six, the CMC or Spike, Adventure Time gives pretty much every character a day in the limelight at some point, even minor characters or even newly introduced ones. Going back to MLP, let's take Slice of Life as an example. It established a personality for a bunch of background ponies, and while I personally enjoy the episode, I can understand that some think it's a bit too overcrowded. But now every pony in that episode could get their own episode devoted to them. While Bong Bong and Lara might be unable to carry an entire 20-minute episode, a 10-minute episode is a completely different story. We already got something similar with the Friendship Game shorts. They were only 3 minutes long, but they could easily be extended to 10 minutes. And I would love to see a couple of episodes like that. Okay, now I talked about the benefits of 10-minute episodes, but it probably won't happen, and maybe that's for the better. After all, there are several cartoons that have 20-minute episodes and are doing just fine, and like I said, MLP is one of my favorite cartoons anyway, so it does something right. But there's another way to fix the pacing issues of some episodes. Introduce a two-story structure to the show. MLP does it from time to time, but most episodes have a very streamlined narrative, focusing only on one perspective. And in general, there's nothing wrong with that. But once you start to pad out your running time with pointless filler or repetition, we have a problem. As such, it is actually rather common for TV shows to tell two or more stories at the same time. Those two plotlines can tie into each other or can be completely independent. Want a couple of examples? For example, Kim Possible. Half of the episode is focusing on Kim saving the world, while the other half is high school drama. Or how about Avatar The Last Airbender? The narrative, in particular in the beginning, is often split between the gang and Zuko, with the plotlines of mirroring each other and coming together at the end for a fight scene. One MLP episode that would have benefited from having such a plot structure is Applejack's Day Off. It had those pacing and padding issues I mentioned earlier, and actually sets up the subplot of Twilight taking over AJ's chores, but doesn't show any of it until the very end. Instead, they stretch AJ's and Rarity's scenes at the spa unnecessarily long, when they could have simply cut to Twilight a couple of times showing her screwing up AJ's instructions. It wasted some potentially good comedy. Heck, that episode might have been somewhat decent if they had done that. Anyway, I could go on, but I just made a point about keeping things short, so I call it a day. But what about you? Do you think MLP would benefit from having shorter episodes? Can you think of another episode that was too long for its own good? Let me know in the comments. I am Tricky Fox. Stay foxy.
Sly as a fox, you got me under your spell. But you know I'll never tell that I know you know so well.